So the difference between 3-3 and 3-1 is with 3-1 you were finding you graphed your two equations and then they intersected at one point and that was your like one solution. Here we're gonna do inequalities. So your solution isn't one answer, it's like a region. So it's gonna be an area, a shaded area. So if you remember from chapter 2 with inequalities, you graph a line and then you shade. So now we're gonna graph another line and we're gonna shade. And then the area where we shaded both, that's your solution set. So it's like your double shaded region. So I'm going to use colors so that we can see that area. Except I feel like I'm missing colors. Where did my colors go?
I have three.
You have one. All right, so let's look at this first equation. So that first equation, probably don't want to be graphing intercepts. I mean, maybe you want maybe the y-intercept, but the x-intercept is going to be a fraction. So we want to put this in slope-intercept form. Okay, so to put this in slope-intercept form, first thing we're going to do is subtract 2x. So I get negative y is greater than negative 2x minus 3. And then I have to divide by a negative 1 to get rid of the negative in front of the y. And then we have to flip the sign. So remember now that we're doing inequalities, so if you have to divide by a negative, you have to switch the sign.
Wouldn't it be plus 3?
Oh, I have plus 1. Yes, it is plus 3. Good catch.
Thank you.
All right, so you can graph it now or you can graph it later. I'm going to graph it now. But you could like do this. Well, actually, that one's already in slope-intercept form, so we might as well graph it now. So we have a y-intercept of 3 and a slope of positive 2. So you can either go up 2 and to the right 1, or down 2 and to the left 1. Now you also want to make sure it is an inequality, so pay attention to solid or dotted line. This one. It's going to be a dashed line because it's less than and not less than or equal to. Okay, and then it says y is less than 2x plus 3. So it is in slope-intercept form. You can just shade where the y's are getting less, which is down, or you can plug in a point like 0, 0. If you plug in 0, 0, you get 0 is less than 3, which is true. So you want to shade 0, 0, which is here. So you're, again, you're shading down, you're shading this way. Okay, now we're going to graph the second line. Second line's already in slope-intercept form, so we can just start graphing. We have a y-intercept of 1, that's right here, and a slope of negative 1 half. So you can either go up 1 to the left 2, or you can go down 1 and to the right 2. So is this one going to be solid or dotted?
Solid.
Solid. As it says, or equal to. And it says y is greater than all that stuff. So you want to shade where the y's are getting greater, which is above. Now, when I shade in two different directions so that I can see what the double shaded area is. That double shaded area, that's your answer. So the stuff that is both blue and orange is your solution set. Any point that falls in this region is going to be an answer. So if I ask you something like, is 1, 2 a solution? So that's right here. Is that in the double shaded region? Yes. Okay, and you can check it. You can plug it into both of those. You should get two statements for both. Okay, so anything in here. Now, if you want, you can choose to just shade the answer. So you could like shade at the end. And I'll show you how to do that in the next question. So that would be just the answer. I can't remember what Math Excel does. I think with Math Excel, you only shade the answer region. I don't think you shade and then shade. I think it just says like shade at the end. So when we do the next example, I'll show you how to just shade at the end. So any questions on this guy? No? Okay, so the next one. Next one's kind of different. It just says x is less than or equal to 4. So that's not slope-intercept form. It's not standard form. It's not like a form because this line is a vertical line. So anytime you see x equals a number or x is less than a number, you're going to go to that number for x. So this is where x is 1, 2, 3, and 4. Now if x is less than 4, then it's everything to the left of 4. If x is equal to 4, it's all the numbers on 4. So that would be all of these numbers. So this is the line x equals 4. We want x is less than or equal to 4. So that would be everything from this line and then to the left. I'm not going to shade yet. I'm going to wait and I'm going to shade at the end. All right, second line. This isn't slope intercept form, so this is going to be a slanted line. So we have a y-intercept of negative 1. It's right here. What's the slope of this line?
Up, down, 1 to the right 1.
So yeah, you can either go down 1 to the right, or you could go up 1 and to the left. But when you graph this line, you want to make sure it's dotted. Okay, which way would I want to shade, above or below this line?
Above.
Above. So that would be up this way. Okay, so my arrows are pointing at this like triangle thing in here, right? So to the left of the blue line and above the orange line, that's everything in here. So that's how you would do it on Math Excel, because I'm pretty sure it just wants you to shade like your answer region. Oh, shade twice. No, you can do it on a piece of paper and then transfer it to Math Excel. You don't have to do all Math Excel like in your head or on the program. Like I'm assuming that when you do your homework, you probably have a piece of paper next to you. Okay, questions? Okay. Okay, so if x was, if the line x is less than 4 was a vertical line, what do you think y is greater than negative 2 is going to be? Yeah, that one's going to be a horizontal line. Okay, so the first one is just y is less than 3. So you're going to go to where y is equal to 3. 1, 2, 3. This is where y is equal to 3. And you're going to put a line through that value. You only want it to go through y is 3. You don't want it to go through y is 2, or y is 1, or y is 0. You just want it to go through 3. So the only way we can graph a line that only goes through 3 is a horizontal line through 3. And in this case, it's going to be, you know what? It's going to be a horizontal dotted line through 3. That we will eventually shade below, because that's where y's are getting less. Okay, so absolute value, we need to identify the vertex, and then we use a to make two slopes. So If it says x minus 2, that means this is actually translated to the right 2. Okay, well, there's nothing over here, so that means my vertex is at positive 2, 0. So whatever's inside is your x, whatever's outside is your y, coordinate of your vertex. And that's my vertex right there. It's a positive absolute value, so we know it's going to open upward. And there's no number in front of the absolute value, so you're just going to assume that it's 1. So that you're going to treat as a slope. So if a is 1, you're going to go up 1 and then to the left and right 1. So up 1 to the right, up 1 to the left to make the V.
These don't have to be dotted or straight, right?
Well, this one has to be dotted because it's greater than.
Oh, I thought it actually thought, yeah.
Still an inequality. And we want a shade greater than that. Yeah?
How do you know when to go up 1 over 1?
Because there's no number in front of the absolute value, so you're going to assume that it's a 1. Otherwise, there'll be a number there, like 2, and then you would go up 2 over 1. So we're going to shade above absolute value. Okay, so what is above the orange and below the blue?
Everything.
Yeah, everything inside that little like triangle thing right here. So this is our shaded region. Look how cute. So cute.